Hey guys, welcome to today's video. We're going to be doing something a little bit differently today. In this video, I'm going to be showing you what I have come up with as a more efficient way to catch mice. To start, we're going to take a look at the basic mouse trap and ways to use it more efficiently. Then, I will show you at the end how Pringles has improved the art of rodent control for any homeowners out there. So, without further ado, let's take a look at how Pringles can be more than just a tasty snack. Okay, so this is the basic mouse trap that we all know and love. It's a spring-loaded bar which is activated by the triggering lever. To attract the mouse, you typically bait it with something like peanut butter or cheese. If all goes well, the mouse will come, check out the food, and while he's trying to score himself a snack, snap! But what happens if the mice wise up? You're really just feeding them and attracting more friends. And that's not good. You don't like that. Oh no, there's more. Oh no. So, for the sake of my fingers, I have some deactivated traps here. Now, as we just saw, single traps can be raided by mice without getting snapped. Here's the first way I'm going to show you to increase your trap effectiveness. The basic layout is the flower shape with all the triggers pointed to the center. The idea here is to catch a mouse as it's walking across to the next trap. The mice will tend to be cautious with their nose, but forget to worry about their feet as much on the back, which leads to more catches and less feeding. So next, the next one I'm going to be showing you is the satellite layout. Similar to the flower pattern, it will have the mouse not watching its back feet, but unlike the flower layout, all the baited trigger levers are close together, so the mouse constantly pushes to go a little further each time. Problem is, with any of these layouts, once they figure out the safe strategy, they will use it over and over, and then you're just feeding them. Alternatively, you could just choose the pattern you want and dangle your bait from above, so the mice are not paying attention to the levers at all and are focused on the bait above. The key is to hang the bait low enough that the mouse can reach it, but high enough to have them looking up at it. Now, for the moment you've all been waiting for. So you're probably wondering what Pringles has to do with all this. Well, it has everything. First of all, once you've finished your Pringles, you'll have a container whose height is perfect to allow the bar of a mouse trap to swing freely with little wasted space. To prepare your container, smear peanut butter side to side on the bottom of the can. By setting the trap and facing the lever to the bottom of the can, you will carefully slide the trap all the way to the bottom. The curvature of the container leaves no place to stand except on the triggering lever while it tries to get the peanut butter. And for those who don't like the cleanup, Pringles has that solved too. Just slap that lid on and toss it out. And don't worry, because there's always more Pringles.